What's up, guys? Welcome to Neek, which stands for Nerd Slash Geek, and we just got the finale of the MCU's first TV show, WandaVision. And yeah, basically how this is going to work, I'm going to do a sort of, this is all going to be spoilers, and I'm going to start by talking about my thoughts overall in the show, talking about all the overall stuff, and then I'll go through all the different episodes talking about them. Well, besides the first two, because I already reviewed them. Check it out right there. You can see my review for the first two episodes, but yeah, let's get started. So yeah, this show is super creative. It's very different than anything we've seen from the MCU, doing a lot of cool different things, and I always applaud movies or shows when they try something different, try to do something creative. Also, it's just great at building mystery and intrigue. As I was watching through, whenever an episode ended, I wanted to know what happened next. It was great at building this mystery, making me intrigued, and all that sort of stuff. It's also great at creating these sort of off-putting, creepy, eerie moments. And I gotta talk about this cast because it is really great. The MCU is like, if you look at all of their projects have pretty big cast with some well-known actors and stuff, movie star people, and this one is no exception. And I do think it's a really good cast. Elizabeth Olsen is amazing. She totally rules as Wanda. This is definitely her best performance as Wanda that we've seen in the MCU. She does great here. And Paul Bettany also does really great. Like, I was really impressed by him from more on the serious side of thing, but then also so his comedy wise. I didn't know Paul Bettany could be this funny. There's plenty of great, like, on the comedy side in the sitcom elements, he does really well in those too. So I was really impressed by Paul Bettany also. And Catherine Hahn is great as Agatha Harkness and as Agnes. I thought she did both really well and played them off really well. And Randall Park and Kat Denning are just these nice additions to have in your cast to help round it out, add some humor. They're both very likable and stuff, so I very much like them in this. And of course, you have Evan Peters in here. He's really funny. I just really like him a lot. I also loved Wanda's arc in this, and it's really moved her up on my character list, and she's now like one of my favorite MCU characters. So that's really cool. I like what they did with her, sort of using this and using her, like, sort of grief and stuff in the premise in a really interesting way. And I liked sort of how they pay it off in the end. Some really interesting things there. So, yeah, obviously, there's a lot of things the show does really well, as I mentioned. But overall, how I'm feeling about it, I don't know how I feel about it. Some ways. I definitely like it, but there's this sort of weird, like, feeling. Like, I don't know. I feel like I couldn't get into it as much as I wanted to. I was really excited before it came out. When the first two episodes dropped, I was watching it, I was excited. And as I was watching the episodes when they ended, I was excited, I was into it, I was thinking about it, ah, yes. And then as it goes on, there were different points where I got more excited, but some parts, like, I'd watch it and like, oh, that was a really good episode, I really liked it, and didn't think about it as much, and didn't, like, get into it as much. And I feel like I'm like, oh, I want to get into it more. So I don't know, like, why exactly that happened. And I think part of it is being released weekly. It's hard for me to stay into a WandaVision mode and just think about that and just doing it, because I'm watching other things, other shows and movies, so I can't really do that. And I feel like if you release it all at once, like an example was Cobra Kai Season 3 earlier this year. I was super excited. I watched it. I, like, thought about it, was watching it, and then I finished it, and I was still on my mind, and I, like, sort of rewatched some episodes with my parents as they were watching it, and I was, like, really into it for a while, but then I haven't thought about it much since then. And this was, like, not consistent, but, like, every week I did think about it, but not as much all at once. So just sort of a weird different feeling, and I'm not used to feeling that with an MCU project, because I'm used to watching a movie, and that's it, and that's the thing, and I get really into that movie, and then I'm not into it as much. And I feel like just, I'm not really used to seeing it as a TV show. It's really messing with my mindset of how I approach it, and I feel like, oh no, I'm not into this all the time. That means it must not be as good. And then I remember, well, it's a TV show, so it's different. I have to look at it different, and I always go in with super high expectations, so it's also could, like, make me feel disappointed. But then it's sort of weird how it is. But also there are lots of advantages of releasing weekly. Like every week I got to talk about the new episode with people, have a bunch of discussion, come up with theories and stuff. So it's just sort of I don't know how to feel about that part. And I do think part of it is I'm just not used to an MCU show like doing this sort of thing. So it's just weird for me to sort of adjust. So I think by the time we get to Falcon Winter Soldier, as we're getting each weekly release, I'll sort of know how to approach it and I'll still be able to really enjoy it and realize I'm not going to be thinking about this every second, every day, because it's not releasing all at once. But then at the same time, with it releasing weekly, I can still enjoy each episode a lot. But yeah, that's basically for my overall thought section. So yeah, episode 3. This is easily the worst episode of the series for me. I didn't really like this episode that much. It's the only episode I didn't really like. The stuff at the end was pretty cool and stuff, and I did like all that sort of thing. But everything before that just didn't really work for me. Unlike the first two episodes, the sitcom stuff did not work for me, like, really at all. The episode just wasn't very funny to me. Almost all the humor was, like, cheap visual gags, like the stuff with the stork. And I just found it more annoying than funny. I prefer, like, more witty dialogue or better situational comedy, like, using your situations than just, oh, a stork is like running. Like, I've seen that a million times. I didn't find that funny at all. And I think because most of it just is in the house, it sort of feels sort of boring. Like, okay, I want more than just Wanda and Vision just hanging out in the house. There's not much there. And then even with the thing at the end where they already spoiled it in the trailer that we knew that Wanda was going to send Monica out of the Hex. So, like, there wasn't even like a big thing that I didn't know was going to happen. So yeah, easily my least favorite episode. Then we get to episode 4, which I thought was a great episode. It steps away from the sitcom stuff and like sort of goes outside of it, but it doesn't really ruin the mystery. All it tells us is the what and not the how and the why. And I already knew what was going on from the beginning. I knew that there was like some sort of bubble and stuff from like watching the trailers. But even if you didn't, like, you'd sort of catch on at this point. Like, you don't want them to keep pretending, like, for a mystery. If you know the answer, you want them to reveal it. You don't want to just know the mystery and they pretend like you don't know it. So I think this is the right time to reveal it. But we don't know how or why this is happening. So there's still a lot of questions to be answered. And then you also have Jimmy Woo and Darcy, like, thrown in here. And they have some really nice comedy moments. And as I talk about, I really like Randall Park and Kat Denning. And then also, like, it's just really cool seeing at the beginning to sort of see the snap and getting to see like people come back in ramifications. A lot of cool things there, and even how Hayward was able to become the director. There's just a lot of interesting things there. And then episode 5 is possibly my favorite episode. It's either 5 or 6. I think it uses the sitcom elements in really clever ways as they like age up Billy and Tommy. Like they do like their aging thing. That's kind of something that TV shows do a lot when they have babies and they're like, oh, we done all the baby plot lines. We don't want to have to wait for them to be 1 year old, then 2 years old. So they'll just recast them for like a 3 or 4 year old to where they can talk and walk and stuff. So it's kind of like playing with that of how they were babies, but they sort of age up and they like age up. So I really like that. It's cool to sort of see Vision start to like get a mind of his own and start figuring things out. And we really get to like sort of see stuff with him. And then also you sort of get into Wanda's head in this episode. And I think it does a good job of balancing the stuff inside and outside of Westview. I like, that's why I like these two episodes, because they take what I like about the first two episodes and what I liked about episode 4 and kind of mix them together. So yeah. And this has baby Vision. And then we have episode 6, which is my other favorite episode. So yeah, Evan Peters' version of Quicksilver has been my favorite part of the last couple X-Men movies. I was so sad when he was wasted in Dark Phoenix, which I assumed that'd be the last time we got to see him. But here he is in WandaVision. Now I know it's not actually him, but I'm just excited to get any more Evan Peters Quicksilver. And we do get quite a bit in this episode. And it just makes me smile. So much fun. He's a really just funny character in this. Like, I don't know. I just love his personality, and I love his relationship with Billy and Tommy. So I just really like him in this episode. You also have some very interesting conversations with Wanda, like as she starts to figure out that she did this now, but she's like, I don't know how I did this, like, and starting to figure out, is this okay? Like, I like this, and it's like all these sort of interesting things. And then you also get to see Vision exploring himself and figuring things out, and you like get a the cool climax there. I really like both Vision and Wanda in here. And it's really great as you get this eerie feeling as he's like going at Halloween and all the people are like still and stuff. Ooh, yeah. But yeah, just really like this episode. And then episode 7. I thought this episode was good, but a step down from the last three. I predicted the Agatha reveal since before the show even started, but that doesn't mean I didn't like the reveal, because I actually really did. That's what I wanted them to do with the show. And the song is just, the song is great. Agatha All Along is, I've been listening to that like a lot. It's a really great song. And also you have Monica getting her powers, which is a cool thing in there. But like episode 3, I didn't think the sitcom element worked that well. Which is kind of sad because I'm a big fan of mockumentaries. I mean, The Office is one of my favorite shows. Sadly, besides the theme song, there wasn't like much based off The Office. But I found most of it like sort of falling flat. And I think one reason is because it's weird to have them break the fourth wall, because they're actually breaking the fourth wall by having a TV show in a TV show. And there's like another level and stuff. And it's like, I think that's just too much. And yeah. I think it's just at this point in the show, especially after episode 6, it's like, I feel like they shouldn't have done like the comedy stuff. I don't know. It feels like at this point, it's not really traditional comedy. A lot of people are doing other things. Vision and Darcy are talking about like other things in there. There's like all these other things. Like, I don't know. I feel like at this point, the sitcom element just didn't really work. But, yeah, still an episode that did have a lot of highs. And then episode 8 is not the most enjoyable episode, but I do think it is a really important one and a really good one for this show and really helps the show overall. I think it's a great episode for the character of Wanda. We get to dive into her past. I love all these different scenes we get. It's just cool diving into her backstory, fleshing her out more. So, yeah, not my favorite episode, but an episode that I really appreciate that we got. And yeah, that leads us to episode 9. I know some people are mad that their crazy theories didn't come true and there's no Mephisto and there's no Fantastic Four and Quicksilver wasn't actually Quicksilver and, you know, Ralph wasn't, I don't know. People had so many crazy theories, and I think that's why people are sort of mad. They're like, oh man, they didn't have all this crazy stuff. This is disappointing. But, like, I feel like people are going in expecting everything that they're in the MCU to happen just in this one show. Like, this is just one show, and we're getting, like, 5 other shows this year and 4 other movies, and then a bunch more the next year and a bunch of other stuff. So they're not going to put everything just in one show. This is just supposed to be a show about Wanda exploring her grief through this crazy, weird way. And that's what this is. And that's what we end here. I do think it's a really satisfying ending because we sort of close it out. And even if you do want this sort of other stuff, we do know Wanda is going to show up in Multiverse of Madness. So Multiverse of Madness will have a lot of these crazy things that people have been wanting, like diving into the multiverse. But it's not all going to happen in WandaVision. So I just think it's dumb that people are like, oh, this episode's bad or disappointing just because they thought these crazy theories were going to happen. But yeah, as I said, just a really satisfying conclusion. The emotional moments hit, like as she's saying goodbye to them, just was a really great moment. Scarlet Witch's new suit is also really great, man. I love that suit. I think they handle like the people of Westview, like sort of freeing their minds and like going to Wanda, and like that was a really good moment. I think they handled all that really well. It's also the first time we got some action in the show. And I don't think it was some of the best action that we've gotten in the MCU, but it wasn't bad. It was pretty cool. There were some cool moments, but not great by any means. I do really like how Wanda was able to defeat Agatha. I thought that was a really cool way, like using foreshadowing and stuff. And it's cool getting to see her become the Scarlet Witch. Lots of the other characters get sidelined in this episode. And it's kind of weird how White Vision just like flies away and they don't really have closure with that. But besides that, I do think it's a really good episode and I do think it closes off the show well. So if I were to rank the episodes, I don't have an exact ranking. I know at the top would be episode 6, then episode 5, then episode 4, and I know at the bottom, the absolute bottom, at number 9 would be episode 3, and above that would be episode 7. I do think that's the next weakest episode. But I don't know what fills in those other spots. 1 and 2, I don't really know which one's better. I think I'd go 1 and 8. I don't really know what to place. And 9, I don't really know where to place. So those 4, I could shift around a lot. I don't really know. Yeah. So yeah, those are my spoiler thoughts on WandaVision. Comment down below, what did you think about the show? Please like and subscribe. Keep watching Neek.